With the Granite State being the first stop on the road to the election, candidates are known to spend a lot of time crisscrossing the state. But so far, the visits are not many, and some wonder, just where are they? Our Heather Hamill talked to one of our political analysts and has our Commitment 2012 coverage tonight.
Well, Melinda, right now candidates are focusing much of their attention on fundraising, but political experts say that they are also trying to position themselves where it's most beneficial for them.
Campaign season is in full swing, but with so few visits from candidates, it may be hard to tell. But UNH pollster Andy Smith says we always seem to judge what should happen in the primary by what happened last time.
2008 was a very unique year. You had big name, big money candidates on both the Republican side and the Democratic side.
Smith says this cycle is more typical, and when it comes to candidates, some need to be here while others don't. One example, Mitt Romney.
He doesn't need to boost his name recognition and his favorability ratings in New Hampshire. He already is well known and he's been leading in polls here for 2.5 years.
Smith says others may be trying to diminish the expectations for them to do well here, like Michelle Bachmann, as well as Rick Perry.
He has to do well in Iowa and or South Carolina. He can try to ignore New Hampshire, saying it's Mitt Romney's backyard. He's been the governor of the neighboring state. He has a house in New Hampshire. Therefore, he, of course, is going to do well there.
Smith says what's more important than the number of visits to the state is the amount of advertising. And he says John Huntsman, who needs to do well here in New Hampshire, is behind the eight ball on that.
But they have to get an understanding of who you are. And it's much better for you and your campaign to create the impression of who you are and what you stand for than it is to let your opponents do that.
However, the primary is months away, so Smith says there's still lots of time.
You really only have to be here doing that heavy campaigning right at the end when the voters are actually paying attention and deciding who they're going to vote for.
Now, Andy Smith expects New Hampshire to see an increase in candidates come late October, early November. Reporting live, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.